Hello, I'm Dr. David Spach, Editor-in-Chief for Hepatitis C Online. This brief video will review the AASLD IDSA-recommended regimens for the simplified treatment of persons with chronic hepatitis C virus infection. Specifically, the following will focus on the medication dosing and schedule for persons without cirrhosis and for those with compensated cirrhosis. Both of the antiviral regimens recommended in the AASLD IDSA simplified treatment approach have pan-genotypic activity in treating hepatitis C virus. These two regimens are glecapavir pribentasvir, trade name Mavyret, and sofosbuvir velpatasvir, trade name Epclusa. Glecapavir pribentasvir consists of taking 3 pills once daily with food, whereas sofosbuvir velpatasvir requires taking 1 pill daily with or without food. Now let's look at the treatment schedule based on cirrhosis status. When treating hepatitis C in persons without cirrhosis, you can either use an 8-week course of glecapavir pribentasvir or a 12-week course of sofosbuvir velpatasvir. If the person being treated has compensated cirrhosis, the glecapavir pribentasvir regimen schedule does not change. It is 8 weeks in duration. If you are considering using sofosbuvir velpatasvir in a person with compensated cirrhosis, it is essential to first order a hepatitis C genotype. If the hepatitis C genotype shows anything except hepatitis C genotype 3, then the regimen of sofosbuvir velpatasvir is the same as in persons without cirrhosis, a 12-week course. If, however, the person has hepatitis C genotype 3, then further testing with a hepatitis C drug resistance assay should be ordered. The results of the drug resistance testing should guide the sofosbuvir velpatasvir-based treatment. If the drug resistance testing shows evidence of the Y93H mutation, then weight-based ribavirin must be added to the regimen. Note that ribavirin has significant toxicities, including anemia and teratogenicity. Given the complexity of the regimen and side effects associated with ribavirin, it's important to reconsider if the person could instead take the 8-week course of glecapavir pribentasvir. In summary, these two hepatitis C pan-genotypic regimens have some slight differences in the number of pills taken per day, food requirements, duration of therapy, and the evaluation needed in persons with compensated cirrhosis. The good news is that both of these regimens have hepatitis C treatment cure rates greater than 95% in persons without cirrhosis and in persons with compensated cirrhosis.
The production of this Hepatitis C online mini-lecture was supported by a cooperative agreement from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, RFA, PS212105. This project is led by the University of Washington Infectious Diseases Education and Assessment Program.